So good afternoon to all. We were discussing about multiple sclerosis. Yes, as the name suggests, it is a chronic inflammatory condition in which you see, first of all, important terms that we described about were Charcot's triad, Uthoff's phenomena, and next thing that we are going to discuss are the clinical manifestations of the same. So this again, like Guillain-Barré syndrome, is initiated by an infection, and later on, because of the injury, autoimmune disease, autoimmunity, that is body reacts against its own self, leads to various signs and symptoms. Yeah. And we saw the also types of multiple sclerosis, four important types: primary progressive, secondary progressive, relapsing, remitting. Yes. And after that, we are going to discuss about the clinical features. That is, first is the motor manifestation. So this was the cardinal signs that we discussed: nystagmus, involuntary motion of the eyes when you ask the patient to focus the vision at one particular position; intentional tremor, that is two muscle groups, agonist and antagonist, will contract rapidly simultaneously. Again, this is involuntary. And third is scanning speech. Scanning speech means continuously patient will speak looking at something and without understanding the meaning or understanding the function of commas, full stop, anything. They will just read it out like a scanner which scans continuously. So motor manifestation we had discussed. First is weakness or paralysis of the limb, trunk and head muscle. Here we described also about the UMN and LMN. Yes, so more of the times there will be UMN signs and symptoms because central nervous system is affected. So there will be spasticity. But initially, because of the shock, there will be paralysis, weakness, that is loss of tone of the muscles. Movement are slow, stiff and weak that result in loss of orderly recruitment and reducing firing rate of motor neurons. So motor neurons are responsible for firing rate. Firing rate is nothing but kitla muscle fibers ne activate karva for that particular activity, that is altered. Yes. So recruitment of the muscle fibers is altered, and because of this alteration, there will be either over excitation or under excitation of the muscles. Scanning speech, as we described, spasticity will be there and the patient will feel fatigue. Moving forward to second symptom, that is pain. 80% of the patients with multiple sclerosis experience pain. Trigeminal neuralgia. Yes, we had described this condition. Salman Khan has this. Yes, so one half of the face will feel so much pain. Yes, the trigeminal nerve will be under continuous irritation, and because of that, there will be burning type of sensation also in the face. So that is trigeminal neuralgia. This is common, again seen in multiple sclerosis. Paroxysmal limb pain, that is abnormal burning aching pain, will be there. Headache will be there. Le Hermit sign will be there. Hyperpathia. What is Le Hermit sign? We are going to see. So jyare pan patient hota main head flex karso, shock like sensations will pass down the spine. Yes, jyare pan tame patient nu head flex karso passively. Yes, you will do it passively. So patient ne akhi body ma, spine ma, specifically shock like sensations aavse. Yes, so that is termed as Le Hermit sign. Again, it is a diagnostic sign of multiple sclerosis. Hyperpathia. Hyperpathia means normal koi pan stimuli hoy, nociceptive stimuli hoy, exaggerated feel thai patient. Yes, say for example, you are touching the patient. Just by touching the patient feels pain. This is termed as hyperpathia, or you can say hyperalgesia. Chronic neuropathic pain is also common. Why chronic? Because the condition itself is chronic inflammatory condition. Yes, so because of that, there will be demyelination that will be chronic and it will remain for prolonged period of time. Hence, that will be neuropathic pain, abnormality in the nerve. There will be pain because of chronic abnormality in the nerve, that is chronic neuropathic pain. Le Hermit sign, sudden sensation resembling an electric shock that passes down the back of your neck into the spine, may radiate out into the arms and legs, usually triggered by bending your head forward towards your chest. Jyare pan tame neck flexion karo so tyare patient ne shock like sensation from the neck region moves downwards to the spine. Yes, and it may radiate even to the arms and the legs. So that is Le Hermit sign. Yes, again it should be pronounced as Le Hermit sign. Yes, so for remembering purpose it is Le Hermit sign, but you have to speak it Le Hermit sign. Le Hermit sign. Yes, R, M and H are continually you can say silent in the word. So this is again a diagnostic sign you can see in the patients. Specifically, this is again involuntary. Yes, patient jaate nahi karto. So even when initially the patient is coming to you, is in the hospital, at that time you can perform this and you can see the sensations of an individual. yes, so that is a diagnostic sign. Le hermit sign ma thai chesu, you are irritating the meninges. Yes, the meninges of the brain are being irritated, and because of this, there is shock-like sensation passing from the neck region down to the spinal cord. Yes, meninges that are the coverings of the brain, these are not ending just by the covering of the brain, they are extending into the spinal cord also. Yes, so because of injury to any part of that, there will be shock-like sensations. Okay, just yes, okay. So, Le Hermite sign that we have seen, that is a shock-like sensation passing from the neck region into the spinal cord and may occasionally radiate into the arms and legs. Visual changes are also common because optic nerve, which also originate from the sub-region of the midbrain and the brainstem, that is also involved. So, there will be involvement of optic nerve, which produces altered visual acuity. Blindness is rare. So, complete blindness is rare. But visual acuity, that is partial blockage of the visual field, is normal. It is seen in many patients. Optic neuritis, yes, inflammation of the optic nerve directly. Scotoma is nothing but formation of blind spots. New blind spots are formed normally. At the retinal level, there is a blind spot in the normal human being also, yes. But multiple blind spots formed in the retina itself, that will come as scotoma. Nystagmus, as we already described, involuntary motion of to and from movement, up and down or medial lateral movement of the eyeball. Intranuclear ophthalmoplegia, yes. So as the name suggests, intranuclear. So the optic nerve itself is affected as such, which leads to paralysis of the third, fourth and sixth cranial nerves are affected, leads to paralysis of the other muscles, intraocular muscles. And diplopia, double vision. Yes, all these are visual changes that are commonly seen in multiple sclerosis. So this is a normal and comparing it to optic neuritis. So you can see a normal optic nerve, and because of the inflammation, it becomes red. Yes, and that is inflammation of optic nerve, optic neuritis. This is the normal myelin sheath, and here is the damaged myelin sheath. Yeah, and these are nothing but you can say nerve conduction studies that are being followed. Yes, NCS, the same thing we used in diagnosis of GBS. Yes, EMG, NCV, which are termed as nerve conduction studies. So from that you can see these are normal motor action potential, and this is diminished action potential. You can see the gap between. Yes, so this is increased latency, what we described in GBS. Yes, so latency is increased and the amplitude is decreased, both things. Latency vadhi jase, etle ke time from which stimulus is applied up to the response, that is increased. Etle vadhare time lagse, reaction time will be slower, and also the contraction, force of contraction will be lower. Yes, so the amplitude also decreases. This is the amplitude. You can see the amplitude big, much bigger. Yes, compared to here, which is comparatively smaller. Sensory manifestations are also sensory point affect us. We have seen about the motor, we have seen about the vision. Now we are going to sensory. So sensory means what? Anesthesia, complete loss. Paresthesia, burning type sensations. Disturbance of positional sense, particularly lower limb. Lower limb are spinal cord specifically, can affect any part of the body. But when spinal cord specifically is affected, the upper extremity, lower limb already will be affected. Yes, spinal cord kya pan injure thai. Say for example, T10 level affect thai. So below that level already badduj affected avse. Yes, so T10 level karta niche badduj dhime dhime affect thava manse. So it is always a lower limb vadhare affect thase compared to upper limb. impairment of vibratory sense. Okay, can someone tell me how do you check for vibration sense? How do you check for vibration sense? Vibration under comes under which type of sensation? Sense superficial, deep, or combined cortical? Yes, vibration comes under which type of sensation? We have seen the classification of sensations. Yes. Yes, everyone. Vibration. How do you check for vibration sense? Which type of sense is vibration? Superficial, deep, or combined cortical?
Deep sensation.
Deep sensation. Very good. How do you check for it?
With tuning fork.
Tuning fork. Okay. Where do you apply the tuning fork? That is true. Tuning fork is to be used with a frequency of 128 and 256 hertz. That is very true. But where do you apply? If I want to check, say, for example, in lower extremity, where will I check? Vibration check nahi lower extremity ma, normal senses check nahi, deep sensation check nahi, kai rite check karte
ankle and knee.
Ankle and knee. Okay, so at ankle, how will you provide? Yes, Priyank, very true. It is bony prominence always that you apply. Yes, over the bony prominence. So in lower limb, if you want to apply, you can go for applying over the patella, or more importantly, you can apply over the median and lateral malleoli. Yes, so these are the two important positions where you can check for sensation. Specifically, lower limb, we are more important in multiple sclerosis. Yes, so impairment of vibratory sense, that is manifestation of impaired sensation. Moving forward to cerebellar manifestation. So cerebellum is affected, your main posture, involuntary movements, and coordination will be affected. So postural and intentional tremor are there, and ataxia will be there. Ataxia is incoordination. All the features of our main two important types of coordination will be on equilibrium. Yes, this will be tested, and you will find equilibrium is more affected compared to non-equilibrium. Non-equilibrium will also be affected. Ataxia will be there, but equilibrium will be affected. Why? Because it is related to cerebellum, which is responsible for maintaining balance. Balance matter responsible che cerebellum, and because of that, there will be more of equilibrium in coordination testing positive. Speech and swallowing. So dysarthria, inability for the articulation of the bones, impairment in the articulation of the bones, which leads to impaired voice production. Voice produce nahi thai. Second, dysphonia, inability to speak even though articulation is normal. Patient is not able to speak, that is dysphonia. Phonia means related to sound. Yes, so abnormality in production, sound production, this is dysphonia. And dysphagia, as you already know, related to chewing and swallowing, we have described in stroke in detail. Ambulation and mobility. So there will be deviations in walking also. Patient will not be able to do his or her daily tasks, activities of daily living, ADL. They will not be able to do. Yes, why? There will be difficulty in walking because of weakness. First of all, weakness. Second, fatigue. Patient thodu kam kar se lethaki jase. There will be spasticity. Yes, spastic muscles are always weak muscles. So hence, weakness comes into the picture. Impaired sensation. Sensations normal nathi. Posture, balance, coordination. Tranai mate, sensation should be normal. If sensations are not normal, tranai alter thai jase. Visual problems, as we already saw in ataxia, in coordination. Because of this, the patient has to demand more energy for doing simple tasks like walking. Walking pan karu eni mate bahu difficult che. Energy expenditure of the task is too much. Bahu vaj vadhare amount of energy is required compared to a normal healthy individual. There will be staggering, uneven steps. Yes, staggering, that is hesitant. Bahu ghabra se. Ek pan step agad mukwa pela hi vichar se, and it will be uneven steps. Poor foot placement. Yes, the foot, when you ask them, you have to place this foot over this specific position, they will not be able to do it. Why? Because of ataxia. Uncoordinated limb movement and frequent loss of balance. Yes, because the cerebellum is affected, the loss of balance is much more common. Hence, when you are seeing such patient, they require utmost amount of assistance. And the assistance is bahut zarur par se. Yes, and for that you are going to provide your support when they are exercising at the clinic or in the hospital, or even prescription of mobility aids. Yes, say for example, walker, cane, crutches, whatever is required by that individual, and at times even wheelchair. Yes, if they are not able to walk even for a specific period of time, if they are not able to maintain balance even in the static balance, so at that time you might need to give or prescribe the wheelchair also. Cognition, and it is affected. So pseudobulbar effect. Yes, abnormal crying or laughing without any cause. Yes, achanak j haswa mande aur rova mande, that is pseudobulbar effect without any cause. It must be important. Euphoria is the ultimate happiness level of the mind. Yes, so that is termed as euphoria. So patient without any cause feels very happy, that is also cognitive dysfunction. Memory and recall problems, specifically you will see short term memory is affected, then long term, and then immediate recall. This will be affected and recall problem will be there. Decrease attention and concentration. So attention, all the five types will be affected, and concentration of an individual is also affected. Diminished problem solving, judgment, speed of processing, this all will be affected. So problem solving, yes, you give them a simple problem, they will not be able, may that be mathematical, may that be real life situation, they will not be able to solve. Doing a judgment is also not possible. Yes, the best example also depicted in one of the movies of judgment, how to test judgment is to throw a ball near a patient. Yes, and if they are able to see and judge the speed, direction, velocity of the ball, they will be able to grasp it. If not, the ball just will pass through them just from the side, and the patient will be standing still trying to judge. Yes, so that also tells you judgment and speed of processing. It is shown in a movie, Tare Zameen Par. Yes, Ishan, once the Aamir Khan comes to his house, they tell them that this is the problem, and at that time his elder brother tells, like, yes, whenever I throw a ball at him, he is not able to catch it. Why? Because his judgment is very poor, his speed of processing is very slow. Yes, so that is what cognition is affected. Bowel and bladder function, so there can be constipation, that can be urinary urgency or frequency. Yes, even the small amount of urine, if you feel the urge to void, that is urinary urgency. Increase or decrease in urinary frequency, normally for an individual 7 to 8 times per day micturating is normal. Yes, for male as well as female, increase or decrease is urinary, change in urinary frequency. Nocturia, that is increased or desire or passing of the urine at the night, that is nocturia. Yeah. So avare kadiye patient ne ubhu thaine javu pade for the passing of the urine for micturition, or the patient passes in the urine in the night without conscious awareness, so it is also nocturia. Incontinence, that is, as we had described already, inability of an individual to control the voiding. Yes, patient controls na kar sake voiding, and because of that reason it can pass at any moment. Urinary hesitancy and dribbling, so patient does not understand when to pass, when not to pass, so that is hesitancy. And dribbling, that is when the bladder is full, bladder is full and still the urine is formed, so slowly and steadily the urine will be passed out without actual contraction, so that is dribbling. Yes, it will pass out without actual voluntary contraction, that is dribbling. Sexual manifestations will also be there. There can be impotence, there will be decreased vaginal lubrication and impaired ability to achieve orgasm. All the three are possible. Again, it all depends on the level. If spinal cord level, lower levels below L5, if they are affected, then there will be urinary bowel dysfunction and sexual manifestation specifically. Investigations, here also we are going to see CSF, here also we are going to see the evoked potential, that is related to nerve conduction studies, and last we are going to see here MRI. For CSF, shows elevated immunoglobulin, IgG band specifically will be higher. Yes, IgG levels in the CSF, cerebrospinal fluid, will be more, describing injury. Yes, immunoglobulins are responsible for autoimmune response. Yes, immunity. જે આપણે વાત કરી છે અવર ઇમ્યુનિટી વોટ એવર વી આર ટોકિંગ અબાઉટ ઇમ્યુનોગ્લોબ્યુલિન્સ યસ સો ધીસ ઇમ્યુનોગ્લોબ્યુલિન્સ ઇફ ધેર નંબર ઇન્ક્રીઝડ ઇન CSF ધેટ મીન્સ ધ બોડી ઇઝ હેવિંગ હાયર અમાઉન્ટ ઓફ ઇમ્યુનિટી ધેટ ઇઝ સજેસ્ટિવ ઓફ સાઇન ઓફ ઇન્ફેક્શન પોસ્ટ ઇન્ફેક્શન ઓલસો ઇટ રિમેન્સ હાઈ ધેટ ઇઝ વાય ઓટો ઇમ્યુન રિસ્પોન્સ આવે છે એન્ડ પ્રેઝન્સ ઓફ IgG બેન સો સ્પેસિફિકલી IgG વિલ બી ધ મેઇન મોલિક્યુલ યસ IgA IgE IgF એન્ડ IgG IgM, IgG are responsible specifically for different reactions. Yes, so IgG is specifically responsible for autoimmune response. Evoked potential show abnormal conduction. Yes, so the same thing that we saw, increased latency and decreased amplitude. This is evoked potential. And last, MRI, lesion seen in bright spot. That is why the name multiple sclerosis. Sclerosis are the bright spots. Je bright spots apne MRI upar dekha se ke brain and spinal cord ma ghani badi jagyae damage che. Because of this damage, it is seen as a bright spot. So here MRI plays a very significant role. Yes, in GBS, MRI does not play any significant role, but here it plays a very significant role. Treatment. We have seen the clinical manifestations. Now we need to see about the medical. And in overview, I'll tell you about the physiotherapy management of the condition. Yeah. So first moving to medical, so disease modifying agents, એટલે immunity, autoimmune response છે, immunity વધારે act કરે છે, તો immunity ને suppress કરો, so immunosuppressant agents, the drugs which can modify the immunity of the body, so they are Noventron and Bitaceron, Noventron and Bitaceron, the same we can also be prescribing in the GBS, because it is also an autoimmune condition. Corticosteroids, as we had already been prescribing in GBS, prednisolone, methylprednisolone. Yes, for spasticity, baclofen and diazepam. Baclofen is the best drug for spasticity, for reducing spasticity. For pain relief, carbamazepine and diazepam can be given. Yes, diclofenac can also be provided, but it will have a short-term effect. Fatigue, amantadine, hydrochloride can be given to increase the activity level and decrease the amount of fatigue. Yes, but overall, whenever you are going to give any drug for spasticity and pain relief, that will in turn with long term duration, it will decrease fatigue. Yes, pain sensation ocha thai jase, spasticity hoti chahi jase, so directly fatigue level pan increase thava manse. Yes, the threshold level of the muscle will increase and the fatigue will be delayed. For tremors, clonazepam and propranolol, yes, beta blockers can be used to prevent involuntary motions, that is tremors. Remember these drugs, we are again going to discuss probably after one or two conditions when you are going to discuss about the Parkinson's disease. So in that, the same drugs we'll be using again for tremors. For cognition, antidepressants, tricyclines or tetracyclines can be used. So amitriptyline, fluoxetine and methylphenidate. So this can be used as a antidepressant drugs, yes, and they can be useful to prevent the additive effects of decrease in cognition. So long term memory is affected, attention is affected, but concentration effect na thava devu hoy, or patient's willpower does not wish to go it down, or the patient should not be going into the depression or other anxiety or euphoria, so do whatever we have discussed. So depending on that, we want to prevent the patient from going into psychological states, yes, which are abnormal psychological states. So at that time, we want to provide such medication which will help the patient to cope up with the situation. Yes, so antidepressants are the best way they can be prescribed. So these are the medications that we will be prescribing. Coming to physiotherapy management overall, yes, we are not going into the details. So first is management of sensory deficits. So sensory deficits are there. We'll be providing various approaches, various textures through which the sensations become normal. Second, management of pain. So whenever there is pain, your electrical modalities specifically come into the play. Yes, as it is related to CNS, both the ascending and descending pain pathways will be utilized for pain gate mechanism. Exercise training. Yes, exercise training, you need to take care about one thing, that is fatigue. Yes, initially there will be higher chance of fatigue. Medication no timing jo pade, and then you have to prescribe the exercise. So exercise, if you are providing, that will make the patient fatigue. Say for example, 8 to 10 repetition is okay. If you are asking the patient to do 15 to 20 repetition of an exercise, they will become more than fatigue. For the next 2 or 3 days, they will not be able to come. ऑल्सो यू हैव टू टेक केयर योर कोर बॉडी टेम्परेचर ओथॉक्स फिनोमिनल यस जो तुम एक्सरसाइज एटली करो कि कोर बॉडी टेम्परेचर एटलू वधी जाए एने रिलैप्स थी जाए सिम्टम्स एकदम थी वधी जाए यस सो देट यू आर हार्मिंग द पेशेंट सो यू हैव टू टेक केयर maintain the body temperature, monitor the body temperature, and then prescribe exercises accordingly, whichever are needed. Management of fatigue, yes, as we talked about, activity pacing is important. Activity pacing means sawaare sauthi vadhare patient paase energy hase exercise karvani. Yes, so sawaare they have to perform all the activities that are important for them throughout the day. Yeah, bapore enthi ochi, sawar karta ochi activity, evening ma enthi ochi, and night ma enthi pan ochi. Yes. So this is how you manage the fatigue. So if you, they want to do heavy strenuous activities related to work, related to their normal bathing or other activities, physical activities, that should be done prioritized in the morning. Then again, there should be a pace that is given a rest period. Then afterwards in the afternoon, they can after to perform another activities which are less strenuous. In the evening, again less strenuous. In the night, least strenuous. Yeah. Management of spasticity. So spasticity can be managed by various things. There are so many things to manage spasticity. May that be by stretching, may that be by elongating the muscle, may that be by rotational activities, ice application, your tens can be electrical, stimulation can be given. There are many things that can be given physiotherapy management that you will be learning in further classes. So spasticity is also one of the techniques, one of the important impairment. You can say in the multiple sclerosis which needs to be taken care and spasticity khali drugs through nahi thai drugs will help you maintain it for a prolonged period of time say for example 8 hours 12 hours 24 hours max pachi pacho e dose andar jase to spasticity decrease thase baki spasticity normal thai jase it is through physical therapy only the spasticity can be managed over time yes long term ma physiotherapy is the only way you can manage the spasticity not the drugs because drugs have ADR adverse drug reaction yes so there are many ADRs of all the drugs that the patient will take may that be neurological or other drugs also management of coordination and balance you already know how to manage coordination how to manage balance locomotor training yes gait training functional training the same thing that you have learned yes functional task and functional activities what are important to that individual that should be the goal main goal of the treatment management of speech and swallowing for this also various exercises are there maybe related to the tongue maybe related to the larynx pharynx you can even apply tens you can also apply IFT and depending on that there will be better outcomes for the patient cognitive training yes this is again a very big field how to train cognition so cognition it will depend from starting to the basic things understanding how our memory works how attention works how concentration works and depending on that motor learning and motor relearning programs are developed remember the term motor learning and motor relearning we'll be coming across these terms in coming future many a times yes so there are many theories according to that cognitive training is given to the patient okay here we complete about multiple sclerosis so physical rehabilitation Suzanne O'Sullivan we have taken neurological rehabilitation Karen Shepherd and neurological rehabilitation Darcy Umford yes so all the three books you have to refer and see if you have any doubts any questions you have so far in any condition we have described including multiple sclerosis yes any doubts you can write it in the chat yes or no everyone should reply okay sir can give hot pack to reduce spasticity like you said colpack can be given no why do we give cold pack? Yes, the main mechanism is through the application of cold. Yes, there is a Lewis Hunting reaction. Because of the Lewis Hunting reaction, the nerve conduction velocity, the velocity at which an impulse travels through a nerve, decreases. Yes, the main pathology in spasticity is not in the muscle, it is at the spinal cord level or higher. Higher centers, nothing. Yes, the example that we took of pizza. Yes, you want to eat pizza all the time. That is alpha motor neuron ne hamesha muscles ne excite karu hoy. But what is stopping? The higher motor functions, the higher mental authorities are stopping. So, so it is your parents that you are not allowing. Yes, but if your parents are not there, at like a CNS jare damaged you, UMN lesion thay gyu, at that time you are free to increase. So alpha motor neuron directly muscles ne signal mokalse ke haji vadharo, muscle tone vadtu j jase. Yes, so depending on that, you want to provide ke je alpha motor neuron excited che e inhibit thai, or alpha motor neurons directly je nerves through muscles ne signal aape che e inhibit thai or decrease thai ama speed. So for that reason you are providing ice, that is cold therapy, but you should not provide hot pack. Yes, unless and until there is pain on that part. If there is pain, then in chronic conditions it is indicated to provide heating modalities, otherwise not. Heating will increase the local blood supply to the nerves, to the muscles, at least spasticity what's it. In case we want to decrease, it will be opposite action. So that is not advisable. I hope that's clear. Yeah. Okay. Fine. So we'll keep it till here. In the next lecture, we are going to start another condition which a famous personality had. The person is no more, but from the photograph itself, you'll be able to take. So from the next lecture, we'll see that condition. Yes. Okay. By the time, Purva, have you taken the attendance?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So we'll keep it till here. We'll move forward in the next lecture. Hope you have a good day. Be safe.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.